Guys, so we're just down here at Never Never Creek in the Promised Land, and it's so beautiful. But I just wanted to show you this. This is my clear quartz, and I take this everywhere with me.
My name's Callista Weitenberg. I'm an international current affairs journalist. I've covered stories all around the world, but for the past 3 months, I've been looking at a phenomenon closer to home, influencers.
You can make millions of dollars. Millions of dollars.
Under the pseudonym Mia Wild, or at that coastal girl on Instagram, I've gone undercover to investigate the rise of influencer marketing and what's known as SponCon.
Medicinal drops that you put in your water.
I just want to talk about hair vitamins. They literally work.
Ginger and lime flavour is just so good. I've literally, like...
And I've just had some huge news.
We have been accepted into one of the agencies.
No way.
Yep.
This is my producer, Elise Pataka.
You know, they connect the influencers with brands, get you like products, get you jobs.
Don't they have vetting processes?
Yep. They say they have some kind of vetting process in place, but...
And they haven't picked up that we've bought 2,000 fake followers?
No.
So what does this mean now for us? Can we start reaching out to brands?
This means SponCon.
We can start getting contra. We can get the money.
Exactly.
Influencer marketing is now a $15 billion industry, with brands desperate to get their products into posts by influencers with even a small number of followers. And it's hugely powerful. 55% of Australians say they've bought a product after seeing it promoted on Instagram.
Oh my God, it is SponCon. Another one.
After joining the agency, I start to get free products sent to me. In return, I'm expected to promote them.
Some here, magnetic lashes and some tubing mascara.
It's all a bit confusing. I'm not sure if I should be disclosing that I received this stuff for free in my posts. When you watch TV or read magazines, it's clear what's an ad and what's not. But on Instagram, TikTok or other social platforms, it's not as obvious. Sometimes an influencer will include hashtag ad or hashtag sponsored content. Sometimes they won't.
Right.
Oh my goodness.
So this is just a small collection of stuff that
I've
got.
This is epic. This is what I think they call a haul on Instagram terminology.
Definitely. We love those.
Maddie Joy Bockett is a Sydney-based influencer who has nearly 60,000 followers on her Instagram. It's now the equivalent of a part-time job for her, with lots of perks.
I feel like this is every 16-year-old girl's absolute dream.
Oh, totally. It's very cool.
Maddie wears a lot of this stuff in her posts.
So when it comes to stuff like this, how would you label this?
Generally, I just tag the brand and I'll say wearing this brand, discount code, there it is, and that tells you that it's a sponsored post.
Cute little details up the top. I love that they all just shape your body so nicely.
What do you know around the regulation of stuff like this and posting ads and labeling ads and that sort of a thing?
If there's no contract or anything, they leave it to you. If they're giving you a free product, it's you do what you want, you know. Yeah. You post what you want, and it's basically like giving your honest review. I'm giving my review on this product I've done.
And as somebody that's built a really close following, do you ever feel like posting ads undermines that trust at all, or causes a conflict there?
Definitely not in the ones I accept. People know that the brands that I choose to promote are the ones that I use.
Mm.
As well as fashion and activewear, Maddie promotes fitness supplements.
It is the best fat burner on the market that you can get.
So all of this is free product?
Yes, sure is.
That's a lot. It's an entire cupboard full of protein and supplements.
They really want to give us different flavours so that we know what each flavour tastes like.
I had the mango flavour this morning. Apple teeny. Oh my God, it smells so good. This might even be my favourite now so far.
And so I have to ask, how much are you getting paid to do this?
So I get commission through my code that I will promote to my followers. So I only get paid if someone actually purchases the product and uses my code. And of course, this is supplements that I absolutely adore and I use them every single day. So the return is definitely worth it. And it's still like a fun hobby that I love as well. So yeah.
Over the next few weeks, I receive a bunch of free products that I then spruik via my account.
Step one is to apply this no smudge tubing mascara.
I even wrote my fiance in.
Hey, Ben. See what you think of that one.
What have we got here? Skin repair.
So that's a moisturizer.
What's wrong with my skin to repair?
I also post about a detox tea and the benefits of a 14-day colon cleanse.
I use this tea occasionally when I just kind of want to flush the system out and, you know, just have a reset.
Brands will often send a brief outlining what they'd like to see in the post.
So this underwear brand has sent me some free product to spruik online, and they've also sent me some instructions around what exactly to say. And what's interesting here is that they've specifically said do not label it hashtag ad or hashtag sponsored.
There's no shortage of influencers who have spruiked the underwear without declaring their posts as ads.
I've been trying to take some photographs in these underwear, which are incredibly comfortable. And this little one is just so blissfully unaware. Oh, hi.
And so as the SponCon rolls in, I want to understand more about how it's regulated.
So if a brand pays me to post on Instagram and I don't label that as an ad, am I breaking the law?
Really, the upshot is that influencers are covered by the Australian Consumer Laws, which is the ACL. The main prohibition in the ACL is that people who are advertising products are not to mislead or deceive consumers.
So if I post something about hair products, right, and I say that it's made my hair really luscious and in fact it hasn't,
yes,
that's misleading.
That's misleading, exactly. And similarly, if you post something about hair products and you don't disclose that you've been paid to do so, that could potentially be misleading. There are also some guidelines which have been put in place by various industry bodies. However, those are just guidelines, they're voluntary, and there are no real consequences if you don't comply with them.
Overseas, in the US and UK, authorities have been taking action against brands and influencers who don't disclose a commercial relationship or who make deceptive claims about a product. In the US, a detox tea company was fined $1 million and the FTC has sent warning letters to influencers themselves. The consumer regulator here, the ACCC, can apply a penalty of up to $500,000 for an individual or $10 million for a company. But they haven't brought a single case.
So who are the victims in all of this then? Why should we care if an influencer doesn't tag an ad as an ad?
The victims are really the consumers. So if a consumer makes a purchase based on incomplete or incorrect information, then they're wasting their money. There's also a potential that consumers are buying medications or wellness products that aren't properly regulated.
So I'd have like a really strong pre-workout in the morning before my first workout. I'd then have OxyShred throughout the day to keep me full. The other OxyShred pre-workout I'd have for the second workout. And then I'd have OxyShred Sleep, which was meant to be a fat burner for the night. And I got rid of them all when I sort of came out of hospital, but I haven't quite been able to give just this one up.
Nikki Reed is 28 years old. She's been living with an eating disorder since her teens. Last year, she was hospitalised twice after severely restricting her diet.
I was fainting at work. I couldn't stand up properly. I would black out. I went and got an ECG and my blood's done and my heart rate was sitting at about 35 to 40. And my GP told me, you have to go to the emergency room right now.
She started taking OxyShred after seeing influencers promoting it.
They share parts of their life to make it seem like they've got this real intimacy with you. So you do have this level of trust and you become susceptible to the products they are going to sell because you end up trusting them more than the next person. She's showing her like her stomach and she's obviously quite muscular. And it's just straight in your, like it's just this body straight in the face. And the first thing I look at is, oh, I don't look like that. I don't think anybody looks at these kind of photos and feels good afterwards. If you'd like to purchase one off, use this code for your purchase.
Mm.
And it's just...
Is that labelled as an ad?
No.
No. What role has social media and influencers played in your illness, do you think?
if I'm in a really bad sort of headspace and I'm in the middle of a relapse and I see these products, all I feel is desperation. All I feel is I need something to help me because I'm not good enough or I'm not able to do this just on my own.
So what difference would it make if an Instagram post was labeled as an ad?
I think it might not always stop me from looking at it, but I think it would just give like a little bit of a circuit breaker to realize that this isn't actually real. It's not a real person with a supplement that they're recommending because they've used it for them. Just remember, this is paid for content.
I go back through my feed and find the post I made about a detox tea that says it contains natural appetite suppressants. I delete the post. Afterwards, I find out that this kind of product is regulated in Australia and that the company is under investigation for not having registered with the Therapeutic Goods Association. Over the last 6 months now, I have spruced absolutely everything from skinny tea to bikinis to skincare, and not once did I label any of those as an ad, even though I was supposed to. And you know what? There was absolutely zero consequences. Not for me, not for the brands, not for the agency, and not even for Instagram itself. And I want to know why. Next week on Like, Subscribe, Follow. It's time to get some answers from the agents who connect influencers with brands. Do brands know that there are fake accounts potentially on your platform?
Well, I mean, they would be able to see all of that information on the platform. Okay, I don't necessarily feel comfortable with this
And Instagram itself.
Hi there. Oh, yes. My name is Costa Weinberg. I'm from SBS Television. I'm wondering if I could speak to somebody from Instagram or Facebook about their branded content today.
Yeah. Maybe we just start. I'll just get this stopping board.